या गुड मॉर्निंग। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द पार्ट ऑफ द डिजाइन ऑफ रूप्टर्स एंड वी हैव स्टार्टेड दैट पार्ट एंड वी हैव कवर्ड द डिजाइन प्रोसीजर ऑफ द रूप्टर्स। नाउ टुडे वी विल सी द एग्जांपल बेस्ड ऑन द design of the root truss. So we will write example first, statement of example, and then we will proceed with the procedure of design of root truss, and we will solve, we will design the root truss. Okay, so so write down everyone statement of the problem. So design of roof truss. Design of roof truss. So write down problem statement. Problem statement. Write down a Pratt truss. A Pratt truss, so type of truss is given here. A Pratt truss is required for workshop building. A Pratt truss is required for workshop building with following details, with following details, with following details. Number one, span of truss is equal to 12 meter. Number two, spacing of truss is equal to 4 meter. Number three, roof covering that is in bracket AC seat is equal to 160 newton per meter square. Number four, weight of purlin is equal to 100 newton per meter square. 100 newton per meter square. Number five, weight of truss they have given directly, that is again 100 newton per meter square, or we can calculate weight of truss. Then next line, write down the building is situated in New Delhi. The building is situated in New Delhi, comma, take risk factor K1 is equal to 1, comma, height and size factor, that is K2 is equal to 0.88. K2 is equal to 0.88, comma, टोपोग्राफी फैक्टर, टोपोग्राफी फैक्टर, टोपोग्राफी फैक्टर K3 is equal to again 1 full stop full stop. Find the panel point load, find the panel point loads for dead load, comma, live load and wind load. Find the panel point loads for dead load, live load and wind load. So this is the problem statement, and from this particular problem statement we can design this particular Pratt truss for the dead load, live load and wind load calculations. Okay, so this is the problem statement, and this is the given data. Okay, so with the with the help of problem statement, we have to draw the sketch of the particular type of truss. So Pratt truss, how looks Pratt truss? So I think you have drawn the sketch of Pratt truss. So how looks Pratt truss? Okay, I think Pratt truss will look like this. Is this the correct shape? Who will tell me?
Yes, sir.
Is this Pratt truss? Okay. So span of truss, how much given span of truss? I think 12 meter span is given, correct? 12 meter span is given. Now, and this is the Pratt truss. Okay. So now, here 1, 2, 3, and 4 panels we have taken. Okay, so now we will go step by step first. So step 1. So actually, this is the rise of building. This will be the theta, that is the slope. Okay. Okay, so what is step one? What is step one? What is step one? Whether we have written this procedure. So you have to go back one page and tell, you have to tell what is the step one.
Sir, from given span, we have to decide the which type of roof truss is given.
So here type of truss is given. So there is they have given 12 meter span, but they have told us you have to design the Pratt truss. So it means they have given the Pratt truss. So we have to write here what type of truss is a Pratt truss. Like this, you have to write, because the truss type is given in the problem statement. If they have not given, then you have to decide as per for the particular 12 meter span. You can decide how truss, Pratt truss, or any other type of truss, spring truss, Okay, so here they have given type of truss, so you have to decide the you have to write here Pratt truss. So then step two. So what is step two? What is step two?
Calculate spacing of truss.
Calculate spacing of truss. So spacing of truss is also, I think, given. How we can calculate spacing of truss? One third to one fourth of span, no? Or one third to one fifth of span? How we can calculate? What is the formula given? One third to one fifth of span or one third to one fourth of span?
Third one, third to one fifth of the span.
Okay, but here in the problem statement they have given directly spacing of truss. Are they have given spacing of truss in problem statement? They have given, so we can write directly. Or you can, if they have not given, so how you can find one third to one fifth of span? So they have given, so I have written directly spacing of truss is equal to 4 meter. Got it? So then next step, step number three. So what is step number three? Calculate what?
To calculate pitch or rise.
Pitch or rise. So how we can calculate pitch or rise? So pitch or rise is equal to what? Pitch or rise is equal to one third to one fourth, correct? Of span.
Yes, sir.
So here we will take one fourth of span. So one fourth of span is equal to one fourth into 12. So 3 meter will be the pitch or rise. So here rise will be the 3 meter. Are you getting? So this rise is the center height of the truss. Central height of the truss is the rise. So we can calculate the rise by using the formula one third to one fourth of span and one third to one fourth. So we have assumed here one fourth of span, that one fourth of span is equal to 3 meter. Got it? So then next step. Step four. What is step four? Calculate pitch angle, correct? Or slope. That is theta. So how can calculate theta? What is the formula for calculation of slope or pitch angle? So theta is equal to what? Tan inverse of rise upon span by 2. Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
So tan inverse of rise upon span by 2. So the tan inverse of rise is a 3 meter. Span is a 12 by 2. So find this value. So theta will be how much? How much this calculation? Do the calculation first. So tan inverse of 3 by rise upon span by 2. It means 3 by 12 by 2. So 3 by 6 is 0.5. So tan inverse of 0.5, how much?
26.56
degree will be the theta. So here we have written. So this angle will be the theta. So we got the rise, then we got the theta. Okay, so now we have to calculate this inclined distance. So you can now go to the next step, that is step number 5. What is the next step? Calculate inclined length. Calculate inclined length of principal rafter. Calculate inclined length of principal rafter. Calculate inclined length of principal rafter. So inclined length of principal rafter is equal to what? Inclined length of principal rafter is equal to what? What is the formula? If we take the square root of what? Square root of rise square plus span by 2 square. Correct is this? So if we put this 3 square plus 6 square, how much? Or other two formulas are there. If you can use the theta also for the calculation of this inclined length.
6.70. Yes, sir.
Just note 6.70. So 6.70 meter, because this is the inclined length. So inclined length, this is the inclined length of the principal rafter. So 6.70 meter. So other formula is there. So by using this formula, you can write again cos theta. So if this formula we can use, is this correct answer? Same answer we'll get. Span by 2 by cos theta. Are this getting same answer? Span by because we have required these three formulas, because this is the right angle. Okay, so right angle there, we have to find this. So this is known, this is known. So first way this, then this theta is known. So if span by 2 cos theta we done, we will get this. Then again, I think one more formula is there, sine theta. Span by 2, rise by span theta, like this. Again, we got. So, same answer we will get. Are you getting? So, in this way, we can find the inclined length. So, inclined length we got 6.70 meter. Okay. So, then go to the next step. Step number 6. So, what is step number 6? So step number 6 is, I think, calculate inclined length of one panel. Calculate inclined length of one panel. So inclined length of one panel, it means what? So this is the inclined length of one panel. Please see. This is the one panel. This is the one panel. So here, how many panels we have taken? We can take 4 to 6, as I told you. So here we have taken 1, 2, 3, and 4. You can take 5 or you can take 6. Up to 4 to 5, we can take. So here, so we have to assume the number of panels first. Okay. So So here we have to write inclined length of one panel is equal to inclined length of one panel is equal to inclined length of principal rafter divided by number of panels. So here we will assume number of panels 4, as I shown you a sketch. So in this sketch particular 1, 2, 3, 4, so these are the panel points 1, 2, 3 and last two. So total 3 panel points, and total how many number of panels? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can assume here 4 panels. So write down here 6.70 divided by 4 is equal to how much inclined length of one panel in meter? 6.70 divided by 4. 1.676 is the inclined length of one panel. It means, so this is the one panel. So this is the 1.7676. Second one is one. So four panel and for three panel points we can provide. So is this writing is over, then we will go on the next page for next. Shall I go next?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll go to the now next step, that is step number 7. So what is step number 7? I think calculate dead load, correct?
Yes, sir.
Calculate dead load. So now we have to do the calculations for dead load, live load, and wind load. So step number 7 is for calculation of dead load. Step number 8 will be the for calculation of live load. And step number 9 will be the calculation of wind load. So we will calculate dead load, live load, and wind load in Newton, which is acting on a per panel point. So if you see this sketch, so these are the panel points are there. So on this panel, particular panel points, so how much dead load, how much wind load, and how much live load will act. So that we will calculate now. Okay. Okay. So how to calculate dead load? So we have written. So number one. What is number one? Weight of truss we have to add. So dead load is nothing but self weight. So weight of truss in Newton we have to calculate. So weight of truss in Newton is equal to what? So here we have to weight of truss, because weight of truss is directly given into plan area of roof truss, or plan area of one panel. What written? Plan area of
one panel.
Okay. So weight of truss is how much given? 100 Newton per meter is given, meter square is given. Into we have to multiply by plan area. So before that, we will calculate plan area first. Okay. So how to calculate plan area? Plan area of one panel is equal to. How to calculate plan area of one panel? I think inclined length of one panel, please read the procedure, whatever procedure we have written, inclined length of one panel into cos of theta into spacing of truss, correct? Is this correct formula we have written for calculation of plan area? This formula we have written or calculation of plan area?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So inclined length of one panel is 1.676, correct? Into cos of 26.56 degree, correct? Into spacing of truss is 4 meter. So do the calculations. Do these calculations and tell me how much plan area, because how area this 4 meter and this will be the meter. So it will be the meter square. Okay, how much this calculation? It will be the plan area. 5.996. Okay. So now from this plan area, calculate weight of truss in Newton. So weight of truss in Newton is equal to weight of truss in Newton per meter square. This weight of truss is equal to Newton per meter square into the plan area in meter square. So this 100 Newton per meter square into 5.996 meter square. So this meter square get cancelled. Now tell me the weight of truss in Newton. How much? I think this is 599.6, correct?
Yes.
Newton. So second weight we have to calculate. So first weight of truss. So the weight, the formula for weight of truss is what? If the weight of truss is here, it given directly 100 Newton per meter square. But the weight of truss is not given, then what is the formula? I think W is equal to span by 3 plus 5 into 10, correct? Is this formula we have written for calculation of weight of truss?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the but if they have not given the weight of truss, we have to calculate by using this part. Then second, we have to calculate weight of purlin. So weight of purlin in Newton is equal to weight of purlin in Newton per meter square into plan area of one panel. So weight of purlin is again given 100 Newton per meter square into again plan area is 5.996 meter square. So this meter square get cancelled, again same 599.6 Newton, correct? So weight of purlin and weight of truss is a same. Generally it will not be same, but they have given in the problem statement 100 Newton per meter square truss weight. Okay, have you written? Write down, please. Yeah. Okay. Then third load, which is the third load? They have given the weight of roof covering. They have given. So weight of roof covering in Newton is equal to weight of roof covering in Newton is equal to weight of roof covering in Newton is equal to what? Weight of roof covering in Newton is equal to weight of roof covering, weight of roof covering into plan area, into plan area of one panel, correct? Plan area of one panel. So now how much weight of roof covering they have given in the problem statement?
160 Newton per meter square.
So this is in Newton per meter square and this is in meter square. So 160 Newton per meter square is equal to plan area is 5.996 meter square. So this meter square get cancelled. So how much weight of roof truss in Newton? How much weight of truss in Newton?
Nine hundred and fifty-nine point thirty-six.
So this is the weight of roof covering. This is the weight of roof covering. Okay. So I think this much weight they have given in problem statement. So any other weight we have to take? Which weight we have considering the in dead load? I think there are four weights we have seen. So whichever is remaining? Whichever is remaining? There are four weights we have seen: weight of truss, weight of roof covering, weight of purlin, and fourth number. Just we have to see the procedure where we have written this.
Weight of bracing.
So weight of bracing is not given. Okay, so weight of bracing is not given in the problem statement. Generally, we can take these four weights, but they have not told about the either we have to provide the bracings or not. So they have not told about the provide the bracings. So we cannot take here bracings. If they have told us use the bracing weight, then we have to use. Are you getting? So bracing is a alternate option. Either they have provided or not. Sheet will be there, purlin will be there, and truss will be there. These three are compulsory. But if they have not told about any type of dead load, म्हणजे कोणताच लोड त्यांनी सांगितलं असेल की यात दिलेला नाहीये, तर आपण हे चारी घेऊ शकता. Either हे three we have to take. Either these three we have to take. If bracing they have not given, we cannot consider. So here we will take only these three, because bracing, if we can provide, either they have given, then we have to take, or if they have not given in this problem statement, we cannot take. But these three are the compulsory. Okay. So now total dead load is equal to. So what is total dead load? Total dead load in Newton is equal to, now here, 1 plus 2 plus 3, correct? So again, 1 is 599.6 plus same, 2 will be the 599.6 plus again 3 will be the 959.36. So how much total load in Newton? How much total load will be in Newton?
Two one five eight point fifty six
will be the total dead load in Newton. This will act on a whole truss. This load will be the act on a whole truss. Okay. So now we have to calculate the point load on the per panel point. Actually, this is on the half span. This will, because span by two distance we have taken everywhere. So actually this dead load will be acting on this part, half part. Okay. Because span by two, in every formula we have taken the span by two. No, to whole span we have not taken. Okay. So now dead load on intermediate panel point. Dead load on intermediate panel point. Intermediate panel point in Newton is equal to total dead load. See the formula we have written. Total dead load divided by number of panels. So total dead load is 2158.56 divided by how many panels we have assumed? How many number of panels we have taken?
Four.
So how much this?
Five three nine point sixty four Newton.
So 539.64 Newton. It will be the load on the intermediate panel point. And dead load on end panel point. Now we have to calculate. So dead load on end panel point. Dead load on end panel point is equal to dead load on intermediate panel point divided by 2. So this formula we used. So dead load on intermediate panel point, how much dead load on intermediate panel point? 539.64. So this 539.64 divided by 2. So how much it?
Plus 69.82.
This will be the load on the end panel point. So how we can show this dead load calculation? So we can show the dead load calculation like this. I will draw this sketch. So here this is the This is the Pratt truss. Okay, so here the load will act vertically downward on this particular panel points. So these are panel points. So here two panel points are there. One is on this side and another is on this side. Okay, so now so these are the intermediate panel point 1, 2, 3. So this will be the how much 539.64 newton. Then 539.64 newton. Again, this is the intermediate panel point 539.64 newton. Now these are the end panel point of this span, this particular span. So this is the total span is a 12 meter with the Pratt truss. Now these are the two end panels. So this is 269.82 newton, and this is 269.82 newton. So in this way, same opposite side also, this will be 269.82, this will be the 539.64 newton, again 539.64 newton, and this will be the again 269.34 newton. So in this way we can show the, and this is the your dead load. This will be the dead load acting on a panel points. Got it, everyone? This, everyone got it, this how to load transfer on intermediate panel point and end panel point?
Yes, sir.
So if you see, this is the inclined portion, correct? So on this inclined portion, these purlins are there. Niya purlin varti kay to ya sheets astil barobar he patra asel asa ya purlin varti purnapane. हा जो पत्रा आहे आणि हे चौकोन दिसतात हे एंड पॅनल पॉइंट. मग हा पत्रा लोड कशावरती ट्रान्सफर करणार, व ज्या ठिकाणी रेस्ट आहे त्या पोर्शन वरती करणार की नाही, म्हणजेच कोणते पार्ट हे पॉइंट आहेत की नाही. लोड फायनली ह्या शीटचा कुठे जाणार आहे, वॉट एव्हर आय डार्क मार्क, डार्क पॉइंट मार्क ऑन दॅट पॉइंट लोड विल बी ट्रान्सफर. नो, येते का लक्षात? हा इन्क्लाइंड पोर्शन आहे आपला, ह्या इन्क्लाइंड पोर्शन वरती हा असा पत्रा आहे. तो पत्रा रेस्ट कशावरती आहे, या पर्लिन्स वरती. हे जे इन्क्लाइंड दिसतात याला पर्लिन म्हणतो आपण. हे पर्लिन्स आहेत. पर्लिन्स परत कशावरती रेस्ट आहेत, या ट्रस वरती. ही ट्रस आहे तुमची, ही ट्रस आहे. बघा, हे हा जो ही जी एसी शीट आहे, एसी शीट म्हणजे हा पत्रा रेस्ट कशावर आहे, या चार कॉर्नर वरती. म्हणजे ऍक्च्युली हा रेस्ट आहे या पर्लिन्स वरती. हे डार्क इंडिकेट करतोय ना, हे हॉरिझॉन्टली हे पर्लिन्स आहेत. हे पर्लिन्स थ्रू आउट दी लेंथ असतात. जेवढी काय इकडे लेंथ असेल तेवढ्या पूर्ण लेंथला असे पर्लिन्स असतात. मग व्हॉट विल हॅपन, दिस शीट विल रेस्ट ऑन दिस पर्लिन. म्हणजे पर्लिन वरती, म्हणजेच या पर्लिन वरती ट्रान्सफिगर केल्यावर पर्लिन फायनली कशावरती रेस्ट आहेत, या चार कॉर्नर वरती आहेत की नाही ट्रसच्या. येते का लक्षात? मग हे चार पॉइंट, म्हणजेच हे चार पॉइंट प्रत्येक ट्रसच्या अशा पॉइंट वरती लोड ट्रान्सफर होत आहे. सो दॅट लोड विल बी द इंटरमिडिएट पॅनल पॉइंट अँड एंड पॅनल पॉइंट. सो आर यू गेटिंग?
यस सर.
म्हणजे हा जो रेड इंडिकेट पार्ट आहे, हा पत्र्याचा स्क्वेअर आहे म्हणजे वन पॅनल जो आपण म्हणतो, सो दिस इज द एरिया ऑफ वन पॅनल इनक्लाइन. मग हा पत्रा फायनली ह्या चार पॉइंट वरती रेस्ट आहे की नाही हो, म्हणजेच हा ट्रसचा सेकंड ट्रसचा ह्या ही पहिली ट्रस आहे, ही सेकंड ट्रस आहे, ही थर्ड ट्रस आहे. म्हणजे पहिल्या आणि दुसऱ्या ट्रस वरती हा जो रेस्ट आहे तो ऍक्च्युली पर्लिन वर ट्रान्सफर करतो, पर्लिन या पॉइंट वर ट्रान्सफर करतो, कारण पर्लिन कुठे रेस्ट आहे, ट्रस वरती रेस्ट आहे. सो इन दिस वे वी कॅन ट्रान्सफर दिस डेड लोड, लाईव्ह लोड आणि विंड लोड ऑन दी दिस पर्टिक्युलर ट्रस. सो हा वर्टिकली डाऊनवर्ड जो आपण आरो दाखवलाय तो डेड लोड विल ऍक्ट बाय ग्रॅव्हिटी अँड इट विल बी वर्टिकली डाऊनवर्ड. गॉट इट? ओके. सो इन दिस वे वी कॅन कॅल्क्युलेट द डेड लोड. सो नाउ गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप, दॅट इज स्टेप नंबर 8. दॅट स्टेप नंबर 8 इज अ कॅल्क्युलेट लाईव्ह लोड, कॅल्क्युलेट लाईव्ह लोड इन न्यूटन. ओके. सो नाउ, सो व्हॉट इज द formula for calculation of live load? Live load in Newton is equal to what? The formula is 750 minus theta minus 10 degree into 20, it will be the Newton per meter square, into plan area, into plan area of one panel. So this will be the meter square. Okay. So how much theta? How much theta? So there will be the condition. Theta is greater than 0 or less than 0. Sorry. Theta is greater than 10 or less than. Here theta will be the greater than 10. Correct? How much theta we have calculated? Theta value?
26.56.
So 750 Newton minus 26.56 minus 10 degree into 20, it will be the Newton per meter square, and plan area of one panel is equal to how much? I think 5996, correct? Meter square. So this meter square get cancelled. So tell me the final load in Newton by calculation. Theta minus 10 degree. So how much? This is the calculation. How much answer? This much time required to calculate this? किती वेळ लागतो हे कॅल्क्युलेशन करायला?
प्रॉब्लेम
How much this live load?
Your answer is coming in minus sign.
Minus? How it will come in minus? 26.56 minus 10. So this into 20, this will be minus into my, this will be deducted from this 750. So how it will come minus? Minus 10 into 20. हे नंतर मल्टीप्लाय करा, हे अगोदर करू नका. ही टर्म सेपरेट आहे ना, दिस टर्म इज डिफरंट, दिस टर्म इज डिफरंट, हे नंतर फायनली मल्टीप्लाय करा. अगोदर ही मल्टीप्लिकेशन करा.
2487.14.
I think only one student talking with me, that is Nehal Patil. Others, you are idly sitting here. You have to learn this something. Are you doing this calculation? Are you writing this? Or I shall teach only her? Why you are others not discussing? Since the lecture started only, I think voice is reachable to me of only Snehal. If you are not responding, what I should think? हे एवढं इझी आहे वाटतंय तुम्हाला? मला काहीच प्रॉब्लेम नाहीये, माझं मी काम करतोय. नो वन इज रिस्पॉन्डिंग अदर देन दिस वन गर्ल. Why you are not giving answers me? Why you are not doing the calculations? Newton is the total live load. Okay, so now we have to calculate live load on panel points. So live load on intermediate live load on intermediate panel point in Newton is equal to what? Total live load divided by number of panels. So total live load, how much comes? 2487.14 divided by number of panels are, we have assumed 4. So how much this value, live load on intermediate panel point? Thank you. How much is this? 2487.414 divided by 4. How much is this answer? So as I told, the only response I am getting from one student, since you are not giving the answers either in chat box or either orally. Okay, so this is the live load on the intermediate panel part. Okay, so now go to the next calculation, that is the live load on end panel point. Live load on end panel point. So live load on end panel point is equal to live load on intermediate panel point divided by 2. So it will be 621.78 divided by 2. How much it will be? 621.78 divided by 2. So how much? 310.89. Is this correct answer?
Yes.
310.89. Okay. So now again, this load will be the acting vertically downward because this is again gravitational load. Okay. Again, draw this particular sketch. Okay. Okay. So in this way, so these are the end and intermediate panel points. So intermediate panel points are there. This is 621.89, then 621.89, then 78. This is the 78. So this is the 78. Okay. This is 78. This will be again 621.76. This will be again 621.76. And this will be 310.89. So whatever end loads are there, these are the end panel points, and whatever middle supports are there, these will be the intermediate panel point. So in this way, this will be the Pratt truss and this is the live load calculation LL. Okay, got it everyone? How we have calculated live load on per panel point?
Yes, sir.
So please draw the sketch, because this part you have to learn in second semester of this third year. You have to design the industrial set. There will be a 50 marks project and external overall will be there for this particular. So dead load calculation, live load calculation, that you have to do again. So this root truss chapter is very important for in next semester also. And other also, but we have to start from this chapter in this particular project. Maybe I will be there or I will not be there for this particular practical. Actually, practical subject is there, but external overall will be there. So you have to do the project on this root truss industrial shed in the next semester. Okay. Okay, shall I go next page?
Yes.
Okay. So now next step, step number 9. And the very important and critical load calculation of the roof truss is the, which type of load is critical load? Wind load. Wind load is a very critical load on the roof truss, because the wind is a major force acting externally on the roof. So you have seen many times the roof will be the collapsed due to the wind force. Have you listened such news, or have you seen also due to the wind pressure the roof will be the collapse during the rainy season, or some wind cyclone came at that time, due to this wind, your industrial shed or your shed, any type of shed will be the collapse due to the wind force. Have you seen such?
Yes.
Or you have listened also, you have seen or newspaper also such conditions, or such we have read also. Okay. So now, this is the very important, and as per the procedure, we will go for the wind load calculation. Okay. So now what we have to do in wind load calculation? So we have to see, first we have to calculate the basic wind speed, or sorry, basic wind velocity. Basic wind velocity. So how we can calculate basic wind velocity? VB. VB is equal to basic wind velocity. Kashi kadaycha apan sangitlo hota? From where we will take this? Basic wind velocity, VB, from where we have to take? Please discuss. Kashi calculate karto, kutun gheto basic wind velocity?
Sir, IS 875 to IS 1987,
part 3. So IS 875 1987, part 3. From there we can take the basic wind velocity. But how? There is available, but how we decide this is the velocity we have to take? This is the depends on the location of building, correct?
यस सर
सुद्धा आहे, पण ते लोकेशन वरती आहे ना. लोकेशन आपली बिल्डिंग कुठे लोकेटेड आहे. इन द प्रॉब्लेम स्टेटमेंट दे हॅव गिवन युअर बिल्डिंग इज लोकेटेड इन विच एरिया. If you read
New Delhi.
New Delhi. So for New Delhi, how much meter per second velocity is there? That you have to see in this particular IS code. So I have sent you IS code. In the last lecture, after the last lecture, I have sent you. So for New Delhi, how much wind velocity? So on which page number they have given of IS code? I think 53 page number. If you see 53 page number of IS 875. So they have given New Delhi in this particular, on this particular page. Delhi is given.
Yes, sir, 47.
So for Delhi, I think 47. If you see, are you seeing the shared screen? Is this visible shared screen? Yes, they have shown. I have underlined. So here this value will be the 47 for Delhi. Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, so you can take this basic wind speed is a 47 meter per second. Then second. Second, we have to calculate basic wind speed. Basic wind speed we have to calculate. So that is VZ. So VZ is equal to K1 into K2 into K3 into VB. So K1, K2, K3 values are given in problem statement. If you see, so how much K1 is given? 1, I think. K2 is 0.88 is given. Correct? K3 is again 1 given. And VB will be how much? 47. Otherwise, we can take the values of K1, K2, K3 from this particular IS code. Please read the IS code. Table number 1 is for given K1. Table number 2 is given for K2. And table number 3 is given for K3. So you have to read this. For what purpose K1 is given, K2 is given, K3 is given. If you directly copy these values, whatever written in problem statement, then why K1, why K2, why K3? If you read the particular IS code, then you will get. So now, so how much VZ value as per the calculation? So this is the speed, 41.36. This will be again in meter per second, because VB is in meter per second, K1, K2, K3 are the factors. So design wind speed in meter per second. So then number three, we have to calculate design wind pressure. We have to calculate design wind pressure, that is PD we have to calculate. So how to calculate PD? The formula is 0.6 VZ square. See, PD design wind pressure is a 0.6 VZ square. So 0.6 into VZ is a 41.36 meter square. VZ 41.36 is the VZ meter per second of square. So how much it will be? And this will be the pressure. So that pressure will be the in Newton per meter square. So VZ square means it will become Newton per meter square. So how much? So how much this value? Hmm. 0.6 into 41.36 square. 1026.38 Newton per meter square. It will be the designed wind pressure. Okay. So in this particular problem statement, height of building is given. Height of building is given. Please see the problem statement.
Sir, in the problem statement, there is one sentence that the height and size factor K2 is equal to 0.
That is the factor. That is the factor. Height of building, the span is given 12 meter. Like this, height of building is given?
No, sir.
I think in the problem statement, they have told, but I have not read that statement. So, write down in the problem statement. Write down in the problem statement number 6 here. 6 number you can write here. Height of building is equal to 6.5 meter. Like this you can write. Height of building is a 6.5 meter. Okay, so number 4, in this step number 9, number 4, we have to calculate the height to width ratio. We have to calculate height to width ratio is nothing but h by w ratio. So h is now 6.5 meter, w is a width. Width means span. So how much span? I think 12, correct?
Yes, sir.
So 6.5 by 12, how much?
0.541.
Okay. If height is not given, then write down here one sentence. Assume 6 meter to 10 meter. If height is not given in the problem statement, then assume height of building will be 6 meter to 10 meter. Are you getting? Ya goshti khup important ahet. Ja goshti design madhi dilya nastat, tya goshti assume karave lagtat. Ani tya assume karaycha mhantla tar tyachi range aplyala mahit pahije. So assume 6 meter to height meter of height of building. So here 6.5 meter we have taken. Okay. So this is the number 4. Then
sir, write up is remaining.
Okay, so write down. So what is next? त्याच्यानंतर आपण काय केले प्रोसिजर बघा प्लीज सी द प्रोसिजर व्हॉट वी हॅव डन आफ्टर दिस हाइट टू विड्थ रेशो Okay, your writing is over?
Yes, sir.
So we have assumed, let us assume, let us assume the building have normal The building have normal permeability. The building have normal permeability. So for this normal permeability, capital A will be the internal wind coefficient. The internal wind coefficient will be plus minus 0.2p. We have to take. And we have to calculate external wind coefficient. Okay. So external wind coefficients we have to calculate. This is the internal wind coefficient. So now external wind coefficients. So in the external wind coefficients, there are how many cases? So in the external wind coefficients, there will be the case 1 and case 2. So case 1, what is case 1? Wind normal or perpendicular to the ridge. It means 90 degree. Now for this, we have to take the values for the windward and leeward side. As I told you, we have to go now page number 16. This is the windward side, this is the leeward side. So windward side, it means the whatever wind force will be acting in this direction. So that direction is the windward side and the opposite direction of the wind force will be the leeward side and internal pressure will be the 0.2 minus 0.2. Plus minus 0.2p. So now we have to calculate here from the page number 16 for the calculated slope or theta, we have to calculate the windward coefficient and leeward coefficients. So for the case 1, so case 1 will be the wind normal to the ridge, that is the 90 degree. So it means wind will act 90 degree on this particular roof area. Okay. So, for that, we have to go page number 16, IS 875, part 3. So, theta. So, our calculated theta is how much? So how much our calculated theta?
26.56.
It means this is in between 20 degree and 30 degree. But H by W ratio is how much? Here, H by W ratio is required. So H by W ratio is 0.54. It means go to page number 16. Go to page number 16, IS 875 part 3. So this is the page. Okay. So either, so I will share the page. Is this page is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So our H by W value is 0.54. Okay. So in which condition? 1, 2, and 3 conditions are there. So is this less than 1/2? 0.54 is less than 1/2?
No, sir.
Then 1/2, it is greater than 1/2 and less than 3/2, correct?
Yes, sir.
It means we have to see this row number 2. This row we have to see. Second, are you getting everyone? Second row. Now, 20 degree and 30 degree. Our theta will be in between 20 to 30. So now we have to take this for 0 degree and for 90 degree. For this wind angle 90 degree and wind angle 0 degree. So for these two, we have to take these values. So see, for 20 and 30, for wind angle is a perpendicular to the ridge, 90 degree. So I think this will be the wind pressure. So for 90 degree, minus 0.8, minus 0.8, minus 0.6, minus 0.8. So please write down this. Minus 0.8. Minus 0.8. Minus 0.8. Minus 0.6. Minus 0.8. Now we have to calculate these values. These values for case 1, and H by D is our range will be the like this. So in this way, we have to write H by W, theta, windward coefficient, leeward coefficients for this side. So now same case 2. Again, case 2, H by W, theta, windward coefficients. What is case 2 now? Case 2 is a wind parallel to ridge. Wind parallel to ridge, it means 0 degree. Okay. So then, wind parallel to ridge. So then write down again, windward coefficient, leeward coefficients. So this is again 1/2. Less than HW, HW is a greater than 3/2. So again, theta will be 26.56. So what are the coefficients? This is here 20, here 30. So these values we have to calculate for 26.56. For 20, 30. For 20 and 30. For this second condition, minus 0.7, minus 0.2p, minus 0.5, minus 0.5, correct? Are you able to see this? And are you getting how I taken these values? सिमिलरली ह्या लिहिलेत आपण पुढच्या. दीज फोर व्हॅल्यूज वी हॅव रिटन, बट दीज आर दीज फोर व्हॅल्यूज फॉर झिरो डिग्री, दीज आर दी फॉर 90 डिग्री. हियर रिटन झिरो डिग्री अँड 90 डिग्री. सो फॉर 20 डिग्री अँड 30 डिग्री, -0.7, -0.2, -0.5, -0.5. आर यू गेटिंग दिस?
Yes, sir.
So now we can write here. This is -0.7. This is -0.2. This is -0.5, -0.5. So why this minus will be there? As I told in the last lecture, minus or negative indication, it means uplift the your truss. So negative sign indicate the coefficient is a negative, indicating the truss will be the lifting due to the pressure, wind pressure. So that here all the whatever windward and leeward coefficients are there, these four coefficients will be the negative, because I think here uplift pressure will be there due to these coefficients. Okay, so write down this, then we will calculate the combined internal and external coefficients for case 1 and case 2. So this we have taken from IS 875 part 3. So this step is very important, very IMP step is we have to go page number 16, IS 875 part 3, which is for wind load. So have you written this? Go fast.
One minute, please.
Please write fast. Write down fast. I will take 1 minute. Only 1 minute break. Okay, so now we have to find the windward and leeward coefficients, whatever question mark we have given. So this question mark values we have to now find by interpolation formula, because the values of windward and leeward coefficients for both the cases we got for 20 degree and 30 degree. For 20 degree and 30 degree, these values will got. Now for the 26.56 degree theta, or slope, we have to find these values by interpolation. Okay. So, now we have to calculate this. So for, again for case one, combine internal and external coefficient. For case one, combine internal and external coefficient is equal to CPE is equal to. So whatever formula we have written in the last time, that formula is here for windward, or windward coefficient. CPE is equal to windward coefficients minus difference of windward coefficient divided by difference of slope into obtained slope minus minimum slope. See, windward coefficients we are finding. So windward coefficients, which is the windward coefficient first? So this will be the minus 0.8. So here minus 0.8 minus difference of windward coefficients minus point, see the difference, minus 0.8 minus minus 0.8, both windward coefficients are negative, minus difference of slope 30 minus 20 into obtained slope is a 26.56 minus 20. So how much this calculation? Please use proper signs, negative signs. Negative signs properly use kara, and please tell me the calculation. Do the calculation fast. Meanwhile, I will write second, that is the leeward coefficient. So again, CP is equal to leeward coefficients minus, same formula we have to use, difference of leeward coefficient divided by difference of slope into obtained slope minus minimum slope. So tell me above answer. So again, leeward coefficient minus 5.248 minus 5.248. Actually, this is not combined. This is not combined because here not added. This is the only windward coefficient and leeward coefficients we are calculating. This is minus 5.248. How? This is the for 20 minus 0.8. For 30, minus 0.8. Then for 26.56, how much will be there? I think this will be 0.8. अच्छा एवडी चेल अब ये थे का कहीं एवडी थी माइनस पॉइंट एट चेल अब जी वैल्यू दिस वैल्यू विल बी दी माइनस पॉइंट एट ओके सिमिलरली फॉर नेक्स्ट फॉर माइनस पॉइंट एट माइनस difference of slope minus 0.8 minus minus 0.6 divided by 30 minus 20 into obtained slope is 26.56 minus 20. Do these calculations again first. So now case 1 windward and leeward coefficients we got for theta is equal to 26.56 degree. How much this? Please do the calculations fast. खूब वेळ होता है कैलक्युलेशन्स लगे वी हैव टू सॉल्व इन दी 15 मिनिट नेक्स्ट हाउ मच .66 it means minus 0.668 okay so this coefficient we got okay everyone please write down this then we can go for the next case 2 so case 2 is for wind parallel to ridge so again here we have to calculate windward coefficients So again, CPE, external coefficients we have to find out. So same way, I will not write here same formula, whatever we have written, but we will solve this. 0.7 minus 0.7 minus 0.2, correct? Divided by 30 minus 20. Into obtained slope is again 26.56 minus 20. So how much this? And for small b that is a leeward coefficient. So for leeward coefficient CP is equal to again minus 0.5 minus 0.5 minus 0.5 divided by 30 minus 20 into obtained slope is a 26.56 degree minus minimum slope is a 20 degree. So tell me these answers. Do the calculations fast. For case 1 and case 2, we have calculated the value for the theta is equal to 26.56 degree. So these all the coefficients are for minus 372. This will be the minus 0.372. I think it will be the correct. Okay. And next is it will be the 0.5, correct. So these are the coefficients for theta is equal to 26.56. It means four coefficients we have find. for case 1 and case 2 for the windward side and leeward side. Okay, so now we have to do the calculations combined internal and external coefficients. It means CPE plus CPI. Okay, so now, okay, so write down this also first. So now, combine internal and external, combine internal and external coefficients. So for case one, combine CPE plus minus CPI, CPE plus minus CPI. Into PD. It means this is the actually for case one, we have to calculate design wind pressure. Actually, this is the design wind pressure. So, design wind pressure is equal to CPE plus minus CPI into PD in Newton per meter square. So for case 1, CPE is 2. So there will be a 4 cases will be there. So I will draw here table. This formula will be there. So I will draw table. So case 1, internal coefficients we have to assume plus 0.2p, ekda plus 0.2p ghaycha, ekda minus 0.2p ghaycha, plus 0.2, ekda internal pressure minus 0.2p ghaycha, internal coefficients minus 0.2p, ani doni chi addition karaycha aise, tata CPE windward side la and leeward side la calculate correctly. So CPE plus minus CPI. So here CPE minus 0.8. Ekda plus karaycha, plus 0.2p into PD is a 1026 point. How much? Kiti aalo hoto? Windward side la jo ghaycha aplyala. CPE, हाँ CPE अपन calculate केला 0.8, एकदा plus 0.2p, so plus 0.2 into 1026, हाँ PD, हाँ formula इत एनार है, design wind pressure चा formula इत 26 point how much? 26.38, so how much this value? In Newton per meter square, same leeward side coefficient is for case 1 0.668 plus 0.2p into 1026 Newton per meter. Je kai sign yil te lihaycha itha in Newton per meter square. 615.28 minus 615.28. Similarly, एकदा plus केला एकदा minus. इतो लिले plus minus. Formula बगा design wind speed pressure is equal to CPE plus minus CPI. एकदा internal pressure plus करायचा, एकदा internal pressure minus करायचा. म्हणजे असा table आपला हा तयार होतो. So in this table form, we can, okay. So again here, minus 0.8, minus 0.2 into 1026.38. So how much this? This is again minus 0.668 minus 0.2 into 1026 Newton per meter square. Similarly for case 2. For case 2 again, so tell me these four values. Second value, which we will take? This value, tell me second. Then minus. Konti sangta hai? Sanket? Minus 0.2 chi sangta hai ka?
Minus 0.2 chi sir.
हाँ कितने थे
माइनस 1026.38
जस्ट माइनस
1026.38
एवढी येते सिमिलरली टेल मी थर्ड व्हॅल्यू एंड फोर्थ व्हॅल्यू टिल आय विल राइट हियर ड्रॉस नेक्स्ट टेबल Okay, for case 2, this is windward, this is leeward. So, internal, so design wind pressure is equal to CPE plus minus CPI into PD, Newton per meter square. Yeah, formula che value ita apan put karto. Fakta ekda plus 0.2 pe hetoy internal pressure, internal coefficient, and ekda internal coefficient minus 0.2 pe hetoy. Internal coefficients minus 0.2. So here, so minus 0.372. Third value minus 480.16. Minus 480.16. And fourth value is again. So fourth value is 890, correct? correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these four value we got negative values. It means uplift pressure. Similarly, second table for case two. Case two is for 0 degree, and case one is for 90 degree. म्हणजे एवढे प्रेशर येणार आहेत त्यातला आपण मॅक्झिमम प्रेशर सिलेक्ट करत असतो. सो मायनस 372 प्लस 0.2 इंटू 1026.38. सो टेल मी दिस फर्स्ट देन हियर मायनस 0.372 मायनस 0.2 एकदा मायनस करायचं एकदा मायनस पॉईंट प्लस 0.2 पी एकदा मायनस 0.2 Okay, first answer is a minus 176.53, minus 176.53. Second, okay, Snell, correct. Minus 176. Again here, minus 0.5.
87.
Kunti. कोणती व्हॅल्यू 87 आहे हा मायनस 587.08 करेक्ट मायनस 587.08 न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वेअर इतका प्रेशर असेल थर्ड अँड फोर्थ So how much third and fourth? Third 307.8. 307.80. And third 307, correct. And fourth, fourth is 718.46. Fourth is -718.46. So what are these calculations? Please see the table. Pratyek table madhe apan ekda internal coefficient plus 0.2p and ekda internal coefficient minus 0.2 ghet astana windward che ani leeward che coefficient se -8 ani -0.66 astana apan kiti pressure asel to calculate kela baka. Manjes case 1 kay lihle mi design wind pressure. Case 1 manje kay ita hai design wind pressure. म्हणजेच काय सीपीई एक्सटर्नल कोएफिशिएंट प्लस मायनस इंटरनल कोएफिशिएंट इनटू पीडी म्हणजे आपल्याला हा प्रेशर मिळतो. तर केस 1 चे 4 प्रेशर मिळाले, केस 2 मधून 4 प्रेशर मिळाले. आर यू गेटिंग? सो मॅक्झिमम ऑफ दिस 8, मॅक्झिमम ऑफ इट दिस 8, मॅक्झिमम म्हणजे निगेटिव्ह व्हॅल्यू असेल तरी तो मॅक्झिमम असेल. सो विच इज द मॅक्झिमम ऑफ दिस 8 मॅक्झिमम व्हॅल्यू? I think -1026.38 is minus maximum value, na?
Yes, sir.
So this is the maximum wind pressure will act on this particular truss. So negative it means uplift and positive it means downward. So this is the maximum wind pressure. So now what we have to write from this particular table? So we have to write here maximum design wind pressure is equal to -1026.38 newton per meter square. Now we have to calculate. So we will take 5 minutes more. Our time is closed, but we will take 5 minutes more. So now design wind force is equal to design wind. Ya tikani tumhi uplift liha. So maximum whatever we have taken, uplift, negative sign indicate uplift pressure. So design wind force is equal to, that force will be in newton, is equal to maximum design wind pressure in newton per meter square into inclined area of one panel so this maximum is a -1026.38 into inclined area of one panel. So inclined area of one panel is equal to inclined length of one panel into spacing of truss. So -1026.38 into inclined length of one panel is 1676 into spacing of truss is 4 meter. So how much? So this is in meter square. This is in newton per meter square. So meter square get cancelled. So tell me this value in newton.
-6470.2.
If we cancel this negative sign, then we have to write uplift here. Uplift indicating negative sign will be here. Okay, so write down this. So this is the designed wind force in Newton. Now we have to calculate the.
Sir, value, your return value is not correct, sir. -68.80.85 value is coming.
Recording in progress.
Please confirm. Others, please confirm whether this value is correct. By mistake, maybe calculations will be. How much?